We talked about God. We're going to pray multiple times a day. We're going to have Bible classes. We're going to do all kinds of things that involve God and talk about His way of life. Each day we're going to talk about something different. So for 5 days, we're going to talk about different aspects of character. The theme this year is a world away from the world. And we're coming to a place that's very safe and very fun, where we can stretch out of our comfort zones and do things that maybe we've never done before or pushed our limits. It's going to be a great week. We're very excited to have you here.
Now, there are a lot of experts out there, and many people are going to try to tell you what's true and what's right. There are religions, there's science, there's many churches of God, there are teachers, friends, family. Who is always right, never wrong? Can someone answer that, teens? Yes, sir.
God.
God. Am I always right, never wrong?
No.
Are we right some of the time?
Yes.
Are we wrong some of the time?
Yes.
But God is always right.
To buy your own food and pay for your own apartment and your own car and all that type of thing, things get pretty rough and they start getting pretty scary. But God does say He will give us the strength to come through. Now, a lot of the lessons that you're learning at camp this year are things that will give you that character to make it through. Is that it's difficult sometimes, but you have to go through the pain in order to get the reward.
My husband and I have been the camp hike leaders for the last couple of years. And we believe that duty to God and duty to each other, duty to our church family, is very important. We believe that the hiking program can help with that. There is a duty to complete the task, the program, the challenge that we put in front of the campers. The honor that comes and the respect of each other is very much a duty that we try to incorporate in our program.
How many of you have a goal? Any goal, any sort of goal, any goal in life? Goals are really, really important to have. Goals are something that we all should have of different levels, long-term goals, short-term goals. Our goals, however, should not align with society. And that's what we're here theming about this week. We're here practicing living a way of life that's different from our way of life back home, with our school friends, with society all mixed in, with the pressures of TV and Hollywood. That's not the world that we want to live in. That's not the world that's going to get us to our ultimate goal. It helps us from being aimless and just kind of wandering and meandering through life.
There's the saving aspect, there's the planning aspect, there's the purchasing aspect, and then there's doing something with it after the fact.
But God wants to make us a God being. He wants to include us in His family. He wants to have this family of billions and billions and billions of people. And that should be our ultimate goal. Is to live a life, to build
a type of godly character to make the right choices and decisions that will eventually lead us to that particular goal.
Pressure, your strength is not very great. But if
this is the challenge/team building course. You can't complete this course that we've set up unless you work together as a team. For example, we have the what we call the trolley, and you'll see that in order to complete that, you've got to work together. At first, it was kind of rough going, but then once they got the sink down and started working as a team, they were able to accomplish the distance quite easily. And so we're timing them on it so that it helps them put a little bit of pressure on them too. Now at this age, the responsibilities aren't as much in their life as when they eventually start working full-time for a job and when they get married and life's responsibilities, you know, overtake you. You've got to deal with others. You can't live life just by yourself as a hermit. So you've got to learn to deal with other people, and it's not all about you. And you've got to learn to work as a team on reaching a common goal.
Lower, lower!
The word that we want to remember about evolution is the word false. It is false. And we're going to use that as a key word to explain why it is false. The first proof that evolution is false is because once the fossils appear, they appear perfectly formed, fully developed, sophisticated creatures with no previous ancestors. Evolution also is an assumption that one kind of creature can evolve into another kind of creature. In the book Origin of the Species by Darwin, he had over 800 assumptions. This could be this. This likely might have appeared this way. He used the word might, possibly, could, may. There is a biological law that is called the law of biogenesis. Only life begets life. Begets means reproduces. When you study cells, you don't study rocks turning into cells. You don't study non-life turning into life.
Thank you.
I'm gonna go ahead and erase this.
Had a young man this morning had a gold medal on because he made his bed the best in the dorm. And I said, "Do you make your bed very well at home?" And he said, "No." And I said, "Well, you think your mom might appreciate that?" He says, "Yes." So hopefully we can encourage the young people to take what they've learned here home with them.
Take your camp experience and the spiritual things that we've learned here at camp, and will you apply it? Will you take it home and live it day after day? If you do those things, though, and if you're faithful in those things, your reward will be spectacular. Make sure that all the decisions you make throughout the days point toward that goal.